Hi, and in today's video, I'm going to show you how to create this invoice in Word. So let's open a new document, and I'm going to construct this invoice using several different tables. You can use one complete table if you want to and take out various lines and borders, but I'm going to do it with three different tables. But the first thing I'm going to do is move this cursor down. You see it's in the top left there. I'm just going to hit the return key a few times, and that would just give me the space to put in my title at the top and not have to push it down, so I'm going to put it in a text box. So if we go to insert, text box, click on the drop down and select draw text box. And then we're just going to click and drag out a text box. Then we're just going to type the word invoice. And if I click away, you can see I've got this black border around the outside. I've also got a white fill color. We're going to get rid of both of those. So let's select it. Go to shape format, go to shape outline, click on the drop down and select no outline. Go to shape fill, click on the drop down and select no fill. And then with your text box selected, let's go to the home tab. And I'm just going to change the text, click on the font, and I'm going to select Brasilia for this one. And the font size, I'm just going to click and enter 72 and press enter. Then I'm just going to make that box a little bit smaller. So my cursor's now here. We're going to insert our first table. So go to insert, table, click on the drop down, and I'm going to select three columns and two rows. And then whilst we've got this table in view, I'm going to select this square at the top left here, and that will select all of my table. Then I'm going to go up to layout, and I'm going to go to height. Now the height here will change the height of your rows. So this height here, they're just a little bit narrow at the moment. Just want to give us a little bit more space to put in our text, our readable text. So I'm going to go up to here and I'm going to select 0.75. It's 0.43 at the moment. So 0.75, press enter, and you can see they're just a little bit taller. Now my text, I want in the very center of my cells. So again, with my table selected, go to layout and then go to this section here. You can see that this section here allows you to place your text wherever you want in your cells. So I'm going to select the center one. So now when I type, you can see my text is perfectly centered in my cell. So I'm just going to put all my text in. Now I've just pasted that in because I'm sure you don't want to watch me type all of this out. Now I'm also going to hide all of these grid lines. So I'm going to select my table again, go up to table design, and then in this section here, this will allow you to alter all of your border lines. So here we've got, this is actually to do with the cell color, and we're going to change that anyway. So if you click on this one, the bucket, click on the drop down, and I'm just going to select a light gray. So let's select that light gray, and you can see it's changed the color within my table. And then if we go up to there again, border styles, you can select that and you can see from all of the different colors. You can also change the weight of your border if you want to. There's a vast range there. You can also change the color of your borders if you wanted a red border, a green border, etc. And then this one, more importantly, is the one you're going to use more often than not. This is all the different borders, bottom, top, left, right, etc., etc., and how you use all of these. So at the moment, I'm going to select no border. But when you select no border, you can see that everything disappears. Sometimes it's a little bit more tricky to see what you're dealing with. So if we select it, go up to the table design, go back to borders, go all the way down to the bottom and select view grid lines. Now the view grid lines will allow you to see the table, but it will not be printed. So if you saved it as a PDF or you printed this out, the grid lines would be invisible. You won't be able to see them. So once you've finished with that section there, we're going to insert our next table. And this next table will be two columns and six rows down. And again, we're going to select the entire table. We're just going to make some broad customizations to this table. So this time when we go up to layout, we're going to increase the height to 1 centimeter. So one and press enter. And we're going to put everything over to the left but middle, the text in this icon here. And then again, table design, we're going to take out those borders again. Now, because we've already selected no borders, which you can see here, there's no black borders, just click on it and it will take all those borders out for you. So again, I'm just going to insert all of my text. Okay, so once again, I've just inserted all of that text and now I'm going to customize the table or the text in the table. So I'm going to select these two cells here, then go up to the home tab. Then I'm going to select font size 16 and then click bold. I've obviously got a return key there. And for this one, I forgot to reduce the font size down to 10.5. I wanted it a little bit smaller. There we go. And then if we go back to the original, you can see we've got this line underneath here. So all we need to do for that is to select all four cells. And the reason we select all four cells is because when we go up to table design, go along to borders here, what we actually need to do is put an inside border in. So where you can see that line is in the middle, we have to select those four cells so the line will be in the middle here. So click inside line, there we go. And that line appears just there. Now in the same way, you can select any border you like, but you must select the cells you want it to apply to. So if you wanted a border just around these two cells at the bottom, you'd select these two cells, go to borders, and you would select outside borders, and that would take the border all the way around the outside of those two cells. So let's move on to the next table and let's go back to the original. And then let's just put all the grid lines in just so we can see what we've done. And as you can see here, we've got four columns and we've got eight rows. So let's go back. Now, one thing I've noticed from the previous table is that actually we've made everything in this table 1 centimeter high. Whereas if we do that, we're not going to have enough room. So we've got to reduce the height of these. So I'm just going to select just the cells underneath, not the top ones where we've got this bold text, just the ones underneath. Go to table design, sorry, go to layout. And here we're just going to put in 7.5, press enter. Now you can see if they don't nudge, it's because you've got a return key or something blocking this reduction. So just hit the return key and then you can see they've all reduced in height. So let's move the cursor down here, go to insert again to table. And here we're going to select 4 by 8. Perfect. So if we go back to the original, we've got a wider column here and then three smaller columns. So again, I'm just going to grab all of my text, I'm just going to copy it and paste it into those cells there. And when you paste into a cell, go up to paste, click on the drop down and go to overwrite cells and click. And then in these three cells here, we're going to want everything in the middle. So select, in these three columns, select the cells, go up to layout, and I want to center them. And I'm going to want to center this one at the top here. So let's center that one too. And we're just going to move this line over. So select it and then move. See, I've selected just that cell. If I select just the cell, it's only going to move the line of that cell. So let's go back, Command or Control Z. Just deselect a cell. I'm not actually formally selecting a cell now. I've got my cursor in there, but I'm not actually formally selecting it. So I'm going to move this over. And this is a personal choice. You can move it over as far as you want to or not at all. But I'm going to move those over to about here. And then you can see these three are now not equal distance apart. So to make sure they're equal, select all three columns. It's just these three we want to be equal. Then go to layout and then go to this icon here that says distribute columns and click. And it will distribute all those columns beautifully and equally. Again, we're going to increase the height of our cells again, and we're going to do that to 1 centimeter. So again, layout height, and put 1 in and press enter. And you can just about see here what we've got is, because I pasted these items in, this text here is in the middle, but this text here is up towards the top. So now we've got the table selected, we can just make sure that everything is, in fact, that's going to change both of those. So select this column here, we want the left center, and you can see those blue lines have just moved down slightly. And again, you can see the difference between these columns here where everything's in the middle and these two blue lines are up towards the top of those rows there. So again, select them all and we'll go to center. Again, now they're all beautifully centered. So again, we're going to take out all those border lines. So select the table, go to table design, go to borders and select no borders. And you can already see, because I've pasted this text in, it's actually pasted the color in of this top line. But again, if you want to do that, you can select the top row, go to shading, and then select one of the colors of your choice. Now, if we go back to the original, if we take out these grid lines, Let's go to uncheck view grid lines. What you can see is we've got some slightly darker lines at the top and bottom of this top row, and a darker line at the bottom, then some slightly shaded lines in the middle, and I'll show you how to do that. So we've selected the top row here. Go to the weight icon here and click and on the drop down, and we're going to go to 2.25. Then go to borders and select the top border. There we go. And then select bottom border. Now, sometimes this doesn't always work, and sometimes you'll have to select the two rows there and go for the inner border. Sometimes you'll have to select this row here and go for the top border. Sometimes it can just get a little bit clunky, so you just have to play around with it a little bit. So at the bottom here, in fact, what we'll do now, because it sometimes makes it a bit easier, select all of the rest of the table, not the top row. We're going to change the shading of the line to a dark gray. So we'll go to this gray here. Then we're going to change the weight to 1. And then we're going to go to borders and we're going to select inside horizontal borders. And then we've got all the lines. So let's just take off the grid lines. And you can see now we've got all the internal lines here and they're slightly lighter, but we need that dark one at the bottom. So again, let's switch back on those grid lines. Go to grid lines. And then we're just going to select the very bottom row and then change it again to 2.25 and the pen to black and then select bottom border. There we go, and we've got that dark line there. Perfect. Now let's go to the final part and then we'll put the logo in. So we've got this table here. Let's go to view grid lines. And this is made up of 3 columns and 6 rows. So let's go back, pop our cursor here, go to insert, table, 3 columns and 6 rows. Now, often what will happen is when you start to insert stuff, you can create a second page. It can be a little irritating. So what I'm going to do is the first thing is to select this table and customize it with the heights of the rows. So select it, go to layout, and we're just going to move this to 0.75 and press enter. And again, we're going to put everything over to center left, although we will have to change some of that shortly. And the way in which we get rid of this second page, or to give ourselves more space on this page, we're going to go over to our rulers. So if you can't see your rulers, go to view and then make sure rulers are checked. Hover your cursor between the white and the gray section, click, and then just pull down that margin. And eventually you'll see that that page does disappear. It's giving us, I'm going to do the top one here, just move everything up, there we go, just to give ourselves a little bit of extra space. Perfect. So now let's go and grab our text. So let's select everything here, Command or Control C, and then in the table, we'll go to Home, Paste, Overwrite Cells, and again, we've made that jump. So again, we'll just move those margins up. Perfect. And then we also need to move this line here. So hover my cursor over that vertical line, move it across. There we go. And again, let's select these two columns to equalize them. Go to layout, distribute columns. And then for this column here, we want to move everything over to the right. So select it and go to right center. There we go. And then again, we're going to get rid of all of the border lines. So go to table design, borders, no borders. And then you can also, once you've selected it, you can go to table layout, just take off those grid lines, and then you can see how your invoice is looking. So everything's a little too high on the page. So let's see if we can put our cursor at the top here and just nudge that down with our return key. Let's see how far, no. So go to delete. There we go, and then we can just move the word invoice down. You can move it over so that it lines up beautifully with this outer line here. And then we've got enough room to put the logo here. So if you want to put your logo in, just go to insert, picture, picture from file, select your logo, Click insert. Now, when this happens, everything goes bonkers, but don't panic. Just keep your logo selected. Go to picture format, go over to wrap text and select in front of text. Again, it's not perfect, but we just need to resize it. So grab the corner and just pull it up so that it's smaller. And then you can go ahead and move this anywhere in your document. But I'm going to pop mine about here. You can line it up with the edge there if you think that looks neater, but it's completely your choice. So I've obviously filled all of this out. Some of it you can fill out because you'll use it over and over again. But if you want to save this as a template, it's probably a good idea not to fill out all of these sections here because obviously they're going to change. I'm just doing this as a demonstration. So if you want to save it as a template, then take out all of the different elements that you fill in for each customer, but then go up to File and Save as Template. So make sure that when you save it as a template, it's in this templates file here. That's really important. Otherwise, you won't be able to save it as template. Then again, file format, Microsoft Word template, you just click save. Now, once you've done that, it means that each time you open this in Word, it will be saved as a template. So if I went to open a new document, if I go to new, so I'm at personal here. You can see the office ones are here. These are the ones that will come with your software. But in personal, you'll see there's an invoice here. Now this means that it's been saved to your Word software and now you can click on that and use it over and over again because when you click on it, it will open a brand new document, the one that you saved, you can fill it all out and when you go to save it, it will ask you to save it as a brand new document. So you'll have to call it Invoice 01, meaning that this one is always saved in your software. So if you really don't want to go ahead and do all this yourself, you can go to my Patreon account, which I'll link in the description below, and have a look at the options there to download this particular document. But if it has helped you, please like and subscribe and have a great day.